Pop, Perswayable. What's going on, everybody? So I'm going to be releasing a actual tier guide character rating list soon, who I think the actual ratings of each character is. And in order to do that, you need to understand the concept of tight chitin. So here's my introduction. So this is the beginning of a rank match. Of course, she's going to spawn directly on me. And this is what tight chitin is using these small areas. Now, the magician is the best character at this. This is the magician style chitin. Obviously, you can do it with thief. And really what you're doing, you're not throwing the pallets down too early because you can keep running in between them, right? So you don't really want to throw the pallets down too early. And I'm going to show you three rank matches of when I do this right and when I do this wrong. So I had to throw the pallet down right there because she was getting very close to me, right? And this is early game, so I got to be careful. You can do this against a Joker. In fact, I think it's easier doing this against a Joker only because he doesn't usually have his dash. So here's a juke. There's a juke. So see how she dashed in there? I have to be careful of that against a geisha. So you got to be really careful doing this. Now I'm going to actually, I know I get the boost, so I'm going to do this. I'm going to boost away from her, get another boost. And then she's frustrated with me. We're already at three ciphers soon, and she's going to teleport away. So that's a basic example of tight kite, and I'm going to show two more examples. These are all rank matches. And the biggest thing is learning when to throw the pallet down, when not to throw the pallet down. So this is a Joker that's an emulator user. You can tell by how he controls this. And he's just going to keep circling me, so this is just me kind of using this. He's eventually going to hit me. If he was a regular mobile user, he probably would have crashed into something now, but he has excellent controls. So anyways, he gets the first hit on me, and then I'm really able just to kind of destroy him with this tight chitin that I talked about earlier. And the biggest thing is knowing when to throw the pallet down and when not to. Sometimes they anticipate you to throw the pallet down and they just blindly swing. And that's when you need to really know. See, like, he was trying to use rocket dash right there, because if I threw the pallet down right there, I would have been killed. He knows that, and that's why he just randomly did that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep kind of circling here. If he throws the pallet, then I can go into the arms factory. But I know he likes to use his rocket dash. And so he's probably going to use it here. Yep, so what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to cut this right here. And now I get a little boost. So now right here, I'm actually just going to throw the pallet down. I'm not going to try to stun him. Just keep a little distance. And like I said, this is a tight chitin method. And the best user for this is actually the magician, not the thief. Especially against a smiley. Magician is a hard counter to smiley, just like thief is the best counter to geisha. So what he's really waiting for is he's waiting for me to throw one of those pallets down. And he knows that if I threw a pallet down right there, he would have got me again. So you need to learn that discipline of when to throw the pallet down versus when just to run right through it. So in the next gameplay, I'm going to actually show you where I kind of screw up and where the geisha just randomly swings at me. And because I threw the pallet down, she was able to hit me. And so, by the way, this is the counter to her. You hug that pallet so she can't go through it. All right. And I'm going to show you tight kiting her now. Now, I think it's actually more difficult to tight kite her. See this? Watch this. Right there, actually, I didn't throw the pallet down and she swung at me. So she missed. See, she just did it again. If I'm throwing this pallet down, she's going to connect with me. So that's why you really need to know. This is where I screw up. I try to throw the pallet down and she just blindly swung. So that was my screw up right there. I should have just kept running. I could have done another one or two rotations. So that's the problem with this method, is you really need to get experienced at it. This is your mama's main chitin strategy. And if you're a magician user, your mama is one of the best survivors in the game. If you're a magician user, you have the best advantage. This is the best way to kite as a magician. And that's why, in my opinion, magician is an S tier character. Because if I was a magician right there, I could have gotten away. And so this is gonna be me showing you how to do it again. So here we go. I know she's gonna come after me. And I want you guys to see what I do right and what I do wrong. So again, I'm not throwing these pallets down. I have that area that's fenced in. And I'm really just gonna keep using this to my advantage. I know she's gonna try to teleport or rush through this. That's kind of one of the things that a lot of these hunters like to do, geishas specifically. And as you can see how she just hit that? She thought that I was going to throw that pallet down. And if I did, she would have been able to hit me. And so that's why they tried. That's me trying to put a little distance between us. I'll show you again. Here is at the end of the game. And it's actually funny because this hunter bragged at the end of the match about being able to kill me. And the thing is that right here, all the exit gates are open. All my teammates are alive. So all I'm trying to do right now is just buy us some time. That's it. I just want to buy us some time. Make sure you only need 3 people to survive. I could care less about surviving. So we're going to do the same method again, except this time the pallets are open and you're going to see. So now the pallets are getting destroyed and I'm kind of losing a little bit of my ability to perform it. But I do have this one pallet here. Now I'm going to show you this geisha is eventually going to get me. See that? So I was able to juke her once there, juked her twice, juked her 3 times, and then she gets me the 4th time. So it took her a lot of hits. That I want to show this because you need to know that geisha can go through this method. But this is essentially how you tight kite. That's what it's called. The magician is the best at this. The thief is probably the 2nd best at this. And definitely get this skill down because it's the difference between surviving and being able to kite versus not being able to kite. And yeah, so I hope you guys appreciate that. Check out my YouTube and check out my Fluxer live feed. You guys can see this. And I'm actually going to show the hunter's name because she was being a jerk to me in private channel. So, yeah, you did kill me. Congratulations. Impeccable skill. But eventually, we still won the match. So, don't be a jerk to me. Okay, guys. You have a good day now.